Good morning, children. Welcome to all once again. I'm Mrs. Rani Sheikh from NCMS Chhapra. Today we are going to discuss our fifth chapter from grammar book. The name of your chapter: subject and predicate. So let's begin the chapter. So children, subject and predicate. Every sentence has two parts: subject and predicate. So what is the definition of a sentence? Let's begin. Definition of sentence: a sentence is a group of words that makes complete sense. It begins with a capital letter and end with a full stop, a question mark or an exclamation mark. So children, what is the definition of a sentence? A sentence is a group of words, not single word. It's a group of words that make a complete sentence, not a phrasing words. So you can see, a sentence is a group of words that make a complete sentence. It begins with a capital letter or question mark, end with a question mark and full stop also. So you can see, it begins with a capital letter and end with a full stop and question mark or an exclamation mark. So children, what is the example? Example here: Shanti plays tennis. So children, you can see Shanti plays tennis is a complete sentence. So you can see Shanti, first letter is capital, then end with a full stop. Another sentence is: my cousin's favorite game is hockey. You can see first letter is capital, then end with a full stop. How cold it is means this is a exclamation sign, end with exclamation sign, and first letter is capital. This sentence exclamation sentence. How are you? This sentence ask question. How are you? Then we first letter is capital, then end with question mark. So children, a sentence has two parts: subject and predicate. A sentence has two parts: subject and predicate. So what is subject? Subject, the subject of a sentence is the noun or pronoun about which we are saying something. I repeat this definition: the subject of a sentence is the noun or pronoun about which we are saying something. For example, Anjali loved mangoes. Who loved mangoes? Anjali. Priya learns karate from a famous karate master. Who learns karate? Priya. So you can see, Anjali and Priya are the subject of the above sentence. Anjali and Priya are the subject of the above sentence, as the sentence talk about the Anjali and Priya. What is predicate, children? The predicate refers to what is being said about the subject. It always includes the verb. I repeat this definition: the predicate refers to what is being said about the subject. It always includes the verb. You remember that in predicate always include the verbs and being said what is about the subject. For example, Anjali loved mangoes. Who loved mangoes? Anjali. Piku is playing in the garden. Who is playing in the garden? Piku. So children, what does the above sentence tell us about Anjali? It says she loved mangoes. So loved mangoes is the predicate in the sentence. So you can see, Anjali is the subject and remaining part of the sentence is predicate. You can see here, Piku is subject and is playing in the garden, predicate. Identifying the subject. How to identify the subject? Let's see. To identify the subject in the sentence, we ask who, what before the verb. For example, Piku is playing in the garden. The monkey swings from one branch to another. You can see, children, in first sentence, Piku is playing in the garden. So question is, who is playing in the garden? Answer is Piku. So who is playing in the garden? Answer is Piku. In sentence second, when we ask question, who swings from one branch to another? Answer is the monkey. In interrogative and exclamatory sentences, the subject comes in the middle or at the end of the sentences. So you can see, children, in interrogative sentence and exclamation sentence, the subject comes in the middle or end of the sentence. To identify the subject, ask who, what before the verb. So you can see, children, what did you eat for lunch? So according to this sentence, the subject comes in the middle or at the end of the sentence. So you can see, you, what is you? It is pronoun, that is a subject. This is a subject and it is a verb. So you can see you, the subject comes in the middle or at the end of the sentence. Before the verb, before the verb, here it verb or you, what is you? You is a sentence. So you can see children, before the verb, what is here? You is a subject. What is the national park called? So you can see the national park is subject and called also verb. So you, according to this sentence, an interrogative and exclamatory sentence, the subject comes in the middle or end of the sentence. In imperative sentence, so you can, so children, what is imperative sentence? An imperative sentence gives an instruction, advice, command, request and offer. So that sentence come in this sentence, in imperative sentence. In imperative sentences, the subject is not mentioned. I repeat this line. In imperative sentences, the subject is not mentioned. It is understood to be you. I repeat this line. It is understood to be you. For example, keep quiet. Here not mentioned you, but we say keep quiet. Here not mentioned you, but understood to be you. So you keep quiet. Stop the car, not written here you, but you understood. What is you? Stop the car. So let's begin this exercise. Subject and predicate, question and answer. First question is, circle the subject and underline the predicate in each sentence. Shanti plays tennis. So children, what is Shanti? Shanti is a subject and remaining part of the sentence is predicate. Have you eaten the chocolate ice creams kept in the fridge? So you can see pronoun here. So what is subject? You is the subject and remaining part of the sentence is a predicate. The rivers flow down a mountain. What is river? River is a subject and remaining part of the sentence is a predicate. I have to throw away all those books. So children, I is the subject and remaining part of the sentence, have to throw away all those books, is a predicate. The picnic was cancelled. So children, picnic, what is picnic? Picnic is subject. Was cancelled is predicate. You must climb the ladder carefully. So you can see you is the subject and remaining part of the sentence is predicate. The sun shone brightly through the clouds. So what is here? The sun. What is sun? Sun is a subject. On the chair lay his sweater. According to these rules, we read it sometimes in interrogative and exclamatory sentence, subject comes in middle of the sentence. So here his sweater is a subject and on the chair lay is predicate. My cousin's favorite game is hockey. What is hockey? Hockey is a subject and remaining part of the sentence is predicate. My neighbors go for morning walks every day. My neighbors, subject and remaining part of the sentence is predicate. Have you finished your homework? What is you? You is the subject and remaining part of the sentence. Finished your homework is predicate. She went to the library after school. What is she? She is the subject and remaining part of the sentence is predicate. Now question 2, complete the sentences with suitable subject. I repeat this question, complete the sentences with suitable subjects. So children, the pillow, what is pillow? The pillow is a subject, belongs to my grandmother. What they show on or what they possess? Milk and oil. Milk and oil are nouns that cannot be counted. Samir won the 100 meter race easily. The library is a place where you can read books. So children, what is this? The library is a sentence and remaining part of the sentence is a predicate. The Taj Mahal was built by Shah Jahan. Ted is fond of swimming. Thank you. I hope you understood subject and predicate easily. Thank you.